Good morning, everyone. Welcome back to our online class from American Bridge International School Level 4 with teacher Srini again. How are you this morning, everyone? All right, I hope that everyone is fine, and for me, I'm fine. And how was your weekend? Did you enjoy during your weekend or not? Anyway, I hope that your weekend was fun. So now let's move to our first session all together. So today is Monday, August 30th, 2021. And according to our schedule, you are going to learn about Hangout 4, Unit 2, the new unit. As I already told you for last week that when you see about the writing lesson, it means that the last lesson of the unit. So today you are going to learn about follow the rules. Follow the rules. So every place have rules. Even your family also has rules too, right? Is it right? And the rules are from the leader of the group or the leader of a place. So who is the leader in your family? So your dad, right? Your dad is the leader of the family. So he is the one who create the rules in the family. So your mom and your dad are the one who create the family. And in the school, we have the director. He is the one who create the rules for the student to follow in each branches, right? Sorry, in each branch, right? And in a place of, you know, a workplace, we also create the rule for the staff to follow in order to make their what? To make their company is good or better for the staff, for every staff. Because if you don't have any rule, the people have, if you don't have any rule, it's very hard for you to control the people. Is it right? Like in the school, you don't have rules, so you can, it's very hard for the teachers to control the student. And in the company, if you don't have rules, so it's very hard for them to control the staff in the building. Why? Because the people have different behavior. So when they have different behavior, so they have different way to work. So in order to control them, you have to set the rules in order for them to follow the rule in the company, like this. All right, so follow the rules. Please open your book on page 28 altogether so that you can see about our today lesson about the vocabulary here. There are 8 vocabulary, right, like you can see, but the church is only choose 4 vocabulary to introduce you today. So the first vocabulary is take photos. Take photos. So when you see what? When you see verb plus noun here, the past we should be verb phrase because as verb phrase. So verb plus noun is verb phrase, right? And verb plus preposition we call what? We call phrasal verb. So this one we call verb phrase. Again, and once over you see verb plus noun, so we call verb phrase. All right, so take photos. So photo we refer to the picture that we get from the camera, from the phone, and from computer, right? Is it right? So there are many kinds of machines that you can take the photos. We have phone, we have camera, and we also have computer too in order to take the photos. So sit on a desk. So sit on a desk, we refer to the activity that the people lay on a desk. During your desk mean, so desk is spread on desk is a kind of the table, right? But desk have a drawer. So drawers look like the box, right? Look like the box under the flat board. So you can push in and push out. This one we call drawer. So desk has drawer, but table no drawer. All right, let's go to the word shout. Shout we refer to the activity of making the voice louder and louder. Right? We call an action of making the voice louder and louder. When you try to shout, your mouth, you have to open your mouth big, right? You have to open your mouth or you have to make your mouth bigger and bigger in order to shout, right? And then your voice come out from what? From inside your body. And then it's make it louder and louder. This one we call shout. All right, next go to the word turn off the phone. Turn off the phone. Turn off the phone, some of them might say close the phone. So can you say close the phone? We don't say close the phone. With every kind of electric or with every kind of the machine, we don't use the word close, but we use the word turn off. Right? So you have the word turn off and turn on. And then this one, what? Versus with the word close. And this one versus with the word open. So you might ask, what is the difference between turn off and close? So turn off, we refer to the activity of shutting down off the machine. But for the close, we refer to the activity that we are not open any kinds of something like door, like window, and so on. The book also can say close too, right? The kinds of thing that we use our hand to what? To shut it down or to shut up. So we say about close. But if you want to use the machine in order to what? To turn on the machine, you have to press something or you have to push something in order to turn off of it, right? But for close, you just use your hand directly, right? Directly to close and open. But for the machine, you have to turn off and turn on. You cannot close it because it is the machine. So turn off, we use with the machine, and close, we use with something that we use our hand to what? To close and open directly. All right, class, so hopefully you understand about what turn off the phone. Turn off means switch the phone off, right? Switch the phone off. So why you have to switch the phone off? Because during class, it is rude if you open, sorry, it is rude if you turn on your phone, right? Sometimes someone might call you during your class and the sounds of your ringtone will cover the class. And then it's annoying the classmates and also the teacher when he or she is explaining the lesson. So it is good for you to turn up the phone, or you can what? You can put in the mood or air mood. All right, class. So after you finish about the four vocabulary, hopefully you understand. Now let's go to create sentences. Create sentences here, you just bring all the phrases there and then you add four sentences here. So this app called phrase. Phrase is one verb. This one is verb phrase. The full of this one called verb phrase, verb and verb. Word phrase. Alright class, so about our first session is finished. If there's any question, you can ask your homeroom teacher for more detail. So goodbye everyone, see you for the next session. Have a nice break.